So Deerwalk Teaching Fellowship and a program that we wanted to run was simply because we wanted to give a different kind of experience to our graduate students. Basically, their 4 years, they sit inside this particular campus, they do their internships, they do participate in the club activities, but what is still missing that you think was, they need to understand Nepal better, and more or less to understand Nepal better, they have to go outside of Kathmandu Valley. So we thought of this particular idea that if students go outside of the valley, stay put for a month or two in different places, they would learn quite a few things about Nepal. So that was the basic idea. So next thing was, we realized, okay, they being the students, especially computer science students, it would be very nice, okay, if we could send them to public schools in Nepal where they are trying to teach different things related to the technology, computers, but they just don't have the resources. And resources, especially in the sense of manpower, exactly. So it's more or less manpower, not weapons. Kathiyoda public school, they don't know how to utilize the resources that's there at their disposal. So last year, we had one particular batch who graduated first from DWIT, and our idea was, okay, we'll send them to different schools in Nepal, but since there were just six of them, so we didn't have a difficult time finding a school. So basically, just to reiterate, the program is, before anybody graduates from Deerwalk Institute of Technology as a formal graduate, we came up with this idea that they have to spend at least 2 months, minimum of 2 months, in one of the public schools of Nepal, especially in remote places, and try to teach whatever they've learned over the 4 years, and probably not just focus on teaching, okay, school kasari run garne haru, school ma ke ke activity haru run garnu huncha, tyo chaine school harma garera sikaidiyo bhane, whatever knowledge they have garnered over here, we thought that would be really excellent. So that's how the idea got started. We approached a couple of schools in Siangza last year, and luckily they were approachable, and they said, okay, we'll welcome them. So that's the basic idea about teaching fellowship program. Expectations, obviously we have a lot of expectations, so we're not claiming that we want to change the entire school just by spending three months in a particular school. That you got them, we won't be able to change the school. That what we strongly believe is, at least we can make a dent. Earlier, we haven't given us a chance. I think we will force them to think differently. So that is the basic idea. So, and overall, more than we as an institute, I think we want all students to benefit a lot. So there are different kind of skills, so how people live in that part of the country, and what are their problems. And I think it kind of provokes them to think, okay, there are so many problems. We're sitting in Kathmandu, we really don't know about a lot of things. There is especially right at this test the problem, right? And once they realize the problem, then probably they will be able to figure out, okay, this could be the possible solutions. So expectation, simply put, is students get upfront with the what are the problems that exist out there, and in a way, if they can figure out, at least solve one particular problem, then I think we've done a good service to them and as well as to the schools out there, and in our own way, probably our service to the country as a whole. So that was the thing. What would they basically learn? Like I said earlier, there's nothing like, we're not asking them to spend hours teaching inside the classroom, so they can do a lot of things. They can even say, develop a software saying that, okay, tapaiko euta school ko website chai na tyo pani banaunus, tyale outreach program ma help garcha. They can see, okay, go to a library and see that there are a lot of books, but there's nothing like a proper record keeping. They can teach that. They can even ask students to set up different clubs, and they, okay, you activity gare bhanche and probably learning becomes fun and you learn at the same time bhanne kura pani huncha hola. Despachi, it's more or less, I think even cleanliness and all those kind of things, tyo pani students le sikos ra ani tyo pani ko service provide garde bhane, athawa if they say ki their experience ki how hygiene is so important bhanera in their own little way. So it's not that school harle nabujheko ta hoina hola, kahile kahi ta perhaps unharuko priority mai naparek kuraharu pani hamro student harle garera share garde bhane, I think they will be able to, the especially students will be able to learn, okay, these are the things, and you could have any school problem research, and whatever they've learned, I know, not just over the 4 years, throughout their life sitting here in Kathmandu, this is priority. So this is necessary for the area of the Ramon, so the efficient ones, especially with the help of technology, you know, that is always on the forefront. So again, about if there's one specific goal, if you ask me, okay, what is the specific goal regarding student like he learned garcha bhane pani like, but I think sabse learn garnu problem bhaneki they don't understand the situation. So it's, there's nothing like you present learn garera au bhanera, we don't ask them, we just tell them the guidelines. We literally want them to experience, okay, how life is all about in the public school of Nepal. We're sitting in here in Kathmandu, we have luxury access to so many resources. Tara gaon ma gaera euta school ma here pani, and then I think they would get to know, okay, Nepal ma problem ke raicha student haru par, even those who are really trying to study very hard, what are the hindrances on their way, so padhna kina gaaro hudo raicha, student le kina sakdaina raicha, is it because of teachers, is it because of lack of other resources, and athawa materially nahune context ma jastai aba books haru nai pugdaina bhane we always get to hear. So key reason exactly figure out where any parak, someday they will get to come up with the solution, like even not immediate, sometime in the future. Finally, expectation is more or less we want to increase this particular program, increase in a sense. So ki ahile we are quite a small college, honestly bhanda khari. This year kind of response that we've gotten is Dang and other places about Sulukumbu, Dang, there are Kailali, Kanchanpur. So different districts but then we're getting requests like our school ma pani aidinu na 2 mahina spend garna lai, and we would really embrace your participation, and tapai harko student lai chani hami ekdam welcome garau la bhanera bhanne chai. Our problem with us is we don't have that many people, so I think the only way we can make this program very very big is by collaborating with other like-minded colleges. So one of the ideas that we have is for the next year at least we'll have a lot of colleges will reach out to, and then those who basically buy this particular idea, they want their students to do the same thing, learn about life in Nepal. त्यो गर्न सक्यो भने चाहिँ आई थिङ्क विल बी सक्सेसफुल हो र अनि प्रिटी सुन सक्सेसमा चाहिँ अल आई वान्ट टु एड इज आई थिङ्क इन द सेन्स एउटा लास्ट इयरको स्मल एक्सपेरिमेन्टबाट नि वी क्यान अलरेडी बी कन्फिडेन्ट कि दिस प्रोग्राम हेज बिन सक्सेसफुल सिम्पली बिकज हामीले 2 महिना त्यो स्टुडेन्ट पठायौँ. गुड थिङ द्याट केम आउट अफ वाज after the students returned was their official duty was over, student le chani privately or separately outside of the college unhar student lai feri reach out gare tapai haru feri aidinu paryo, tapai haru le thru kura sikai dinu bhayathyo, tapai haru ko bisay ma kasto garo paryo bhanepachi, and students they went on their own, and so I think that's the most the fascinating part of this entire journey, even though it's not been that very long. So that's it.